Hey, horse people. Cute little colt here. Video used on the Fair Use Act for educational and critique purposes. Let's look at some common mistakes that people make with baby horses. Now, First of all, let me start. I got no problem loving and playing with little babies and letting them be babies. I don't think you need to be correcting them and trying to train them when they're born and all that. But there's certain things that are kind of a no-go item. And one of those is kicking, and the other is jumping or lunging at you, which could be later turned into striking and biting. So those are about the three things that you draw the line and a horse needs to be pushed off and made to go. Otherwise, they learn very dangerous lessons. And when you teach or allow a horse to learn a dangerous lesson, you make that horse's destiny failure, and he's going to have a miserable life. He's going to be sold. Nobody's going to want him. He's going to get labeled and may end up in slaughter or be rehomed, etc., etc. So just because you think it's cute and you allow it and you say, oh, it's not going to hurt, when it turns out bad, okay, so let's I'm going to move this forward kind of slow here to show this little guy some things. So this guy's walking with him, and the horse comes up, baby, and he jumps. Now, is this horse being mean right here? No. Is the horse trying to hurt this guy? No. He's doing what baby colts and baby horses do. They like to play. They like to jump. They like to test out. They like to push things and find things lower than them, because they are the lowest one in the herd. And when they try and push mom or one of the other older horses, they get kicked and put in their place. So they're always searching for someone that they can push around. Because in the horse world, from the day the horse is born, you're either higher or lower. There's no equals in the horse world. So this horse is doing normal behavior. He's not being mean or bad, but it shouldn't be allowed, because that's how horses learn bad habits. These idiots who are bringing their horses, the baby horses, in the house and letting them sleep on the couch and letting them walk around and dressing them up like kids and putting them in high chairs and shit. Those are all things that when a horse grows up, he becomes dangerous. And then when he's dangerous, people label him as mean and vicious, and he'll hurt you, and you should sell him, and he can't be trained, and he was oxygen deprived, and the last trainer screwed him up, and it must be breeding, and we need a bigger bit, and bigger shoes, and more tie downs, and more metal, and all the crazy dumb excuses happen because behavior like this is allowed.
Whoa, what are you doing?
Okay, the guy asked, what are you doing? Whoa. So the guy pushed him off, but did you notice the guy walked away? Remember, pressure and release in the horse world, that's how they live and survive. If you move when I come in closer, you're telling me you're lower and you're moving to my pressure. This guy moved to the horse's pressure. I'm going to move it back here. Step. See a step? See that step back? See the horse showing up? Watch as we go forward, the guy will move away. The horse is moving in. Lower stupid human is moving away. Now the human thinks, hey, you know what? I did good. I kind of gave the horse a little room. I protected myself. I didn't want to get hit. And, everything turned out great. That's not what the horse saw. The horse saw, if I rear on people, they move away. So I need to show two-legged humans I'm higher by rearing and making them move away. Then I can be higher and they can be lower. So, bad, easy lesson. Is it critical? The good thing about horses, they learn very quick. They can learn bad habits quickly, and you can break and unlearn those bad habits quickly if you do it right. Okay, so they put a little clip here. The horse walks up and backs into him. Now, Buddy will do this still sometime, and other horses will do it. But my horses know that you don't ever kick a human. This little baby horse doesn't know that. So this is starting out as kind of cute. The horse is backing in. He's scratching him. Watch him move away. He backs away from the horse. He yields to the horse's pressure. And the horse moves in and gives him pressure. And the stupid human moves away. And he scratches. and now he moves away, and a horse moves in, and a horse is thinking, hey, if I want people to move, I just back into them. This is where people get in trouble. I mean, this is simple for somebody to understand this, but it's not simple for a lot. Oh, it's all fun and game till you got a hoof hanging out your butt. So the little horse just kicked him. Now to me, this was very predictable. The guy walking with the horse was in shock. He can't believe it happened. And it wasn't that bad of a kick. So the little kick is kind of a sideways. He kind of got him right there in the leg. So, of course, my phone's ringing. Hang on, let me turn this damn thing off or it'll be quacking all night. It's Pat. I knew it. If I turn on this damn video, Pat calls. So, anyway, the little horse kicked him. We're moving forward. The horse runs up next to him. The guy thinks, oh, isn't that cute? He's like a dog. He wants to come up and run with me. I'll teach him to heel. It's not what the horse was thinking. Horse is thinking, hey, let me make this stupid human move. Watch this. Bang. Again, is the horse being mean? No. Was he trying to hurt him? No. But if he does that when he gets 1,000 pounds or 800 pounds, you get broken legs. I know people who have gotten broken legs from little colts like this. If he kicked straight out, luckily this little guy was kicking sideways. And that's kind of a sideways kick. He didn't really get in front of him, give him a good rear end kick. So he's kind of lucky. But man, I'm telling you, those little guys kick hard.
Oh my gosh.
You hear that? Oh my gosh. That tells me that she didn't know it was going to happen either. Everybody's shocked that this happened. I'm not shocked. It's totally predictable. That's why when people come here and always put, you should wear a helmet because horses are unpredictable. Horses aren't unpredictable. They're very predictable. People that wear helmets think they're unpredictable. They think the helmet is going to save them, but they don't understand horses. Or they would know that they're probably safer on a horse than they are on a damn highway with all the crazy drivers out there. But this little colt here is not being mean or bad, but these little simple behaviors, these little simple things when a horse is, if they're not corrected quickly, I guarantee you this baby don't go do this to mom. Mom will bite and throw him to the ground or put a hoof in his butt and he'll remember it. He will not do that, and that's how horses learn. That's why horses are the best teacher of horses. That's why horses learn better from horses, and when humans try to think they're smarter and they try to teach a horse, they end up screwing up the horse, making them dangerous, and then they get labeled that they're oxygen deprived, that they had a bad trainer, they got bad breeding, he was scared as a baby, whatever. All the stupid excuses out there. That's not the cause. That's why I tell people, you don't know what you don't know. The people who are labeling and telling you about how horses and acting like they know what they're talking about, they don't even know what they don't know. Horses are very predictable. They're very easy to read. They have a simple hierarchy and herd structure. If you understand that, pressure, release, higher, lower. I mean, they're pretty simple creatures and they learn very quickly. Unfortunately, they learn how to outsmart stupid humans even quicker. All right, well, in that there, buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys.